right, so here he is, the number one UFC middleweight contender. And in this era, that's saying something, right? To get through this gauntlet and emerge out of the pack, realize a UFC title shot. Now the world finds out what exactly this man can do.
You know, John, as we've spoken about, it's shark-infested waters trying to manage and navigate through this division. It's one thing to get here, and it's a major accomplishment. But to become the champion is a whole nother level. This guy feels like in his thorough preparation, the intensity at which he moves in the training room, he is more than ready to take the belt off the champion's waist.
And you can be sure when the champion comes out at a moment, challenger's eyes will be fixed upon him. We got a middleweight title fight tonight, folks. Let's go. So the path to UFC middleweight gold and glory continues to go through this man. And without speaking hyperbolically, I do believe this man looks like he could reign for some time.
You know, when you think about middleweight, you think about some great champions, Anderson Silva and Israel Adesanya. This man can be viewed in the same regard because he has ruled the top of the division for a really long time. He's ruled it with an iron fist. He is just so good in this role. He is everything you want in a UFC champion.
And he's fighting in his natural weight class. A lot of people wondered aloud if maybe he could become a two-division champion, go down to 70. He don't want to hear that noise. He's looking to pluck off another middleweight title challenger in yet another big spot here tonight. All right, now our tale of the tape for this middleweight championship fight. All right, now for the official introductions. We go inside the octagon to Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, presenting the challenger, Dricus Du Plessis. And now introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner, presenting the reigning, defending UFC undisputed middleweight champion of the world, Sean Strickland!
Referee Herb Dean will handle the action in the octagon. All right, early round action here, and as humbly as he could put it, Sean Strickland believes he has every advantage in this particular matchup. He is convicted that if this fight goes to the ground, he will be the stronger man. Also believes he can run some clock in the clinch if need be, given his opponent's obvious striking acumen. But Strickland is no slouch there as well, and there are many reasons why Sean Strickland, methodically over the last 4 or 5 years, has built himself into one of the very best middleweights on the planet.
Got tagged a couple times. Nice combo on top.
Just out of range with that uppercut. Straight right hand on the counter is good. Looks like he's trying to set up a takedown here. There's the attempt. Oh, they're trading huge shots here. We'll see who's the last man standing. Right now they separate. Again with the hook. All right, so a good job defensively by him here as he raises the guard and prevents any damage.
Shades of James Toney. Always seeing things coming at him. He's such a great defensive fighter.
Frantic pace early on to this one. Useful strike there. The hook is clean. Oh, so an interesting decision there as he decides to stand up and relinquish the dominant position.
Oh, nice.
Oh, nice job by him there to slip that offer. Du Plessis gets tattooed by that straight punch. Just over 3 minutes now to go. Straight right is there. Going out of the body with that hook. Well done there by Dricus Du Plessis. Well, he's doing a nice job here blocking these shots. The chin is tucked, the hands are high. Pretty good job defensively thus far.
Great job defensively. He's seeing everything coming.
Big shot on the feet. Well, he keeps going back to the well with that left hand, just out of range. All right, well, good news is he rocked him. Bad news is he wasn't able to finish the job, and now his opponent's back in the fight.
I mean, you don't get those opportunities very often. You got to take full advantage of them when they're presented to you.
He ripped the body there.
Gets to the single collar tie.
Keeping busy here in the clinch and landed a pretty good shot there. Under 2 minutes to go in a back-and-forth first round here. Du Plessis' nose is bleeding now. Looks to be cut, perhaps there on the bridge.
All right, keep pushing forward.
Good jab there by the champion. It's a beautiful, fast, quick jab with meaning.
Oh, big effort. Circling to his right.
Let's open up that cut more now.
Nice block. A double. He's hurt bad.
Beautiful diving strike lands. All right, half guard form here, and a lot of offensive options, I would think, at his disposal.
Oh, he's got a ton of options. He has sufficient options, but I believe the safest option for him here is going to be to use his grounded pound. Build a base. Posture up, throw big strikes, get back to position, do a posture again, throw big strikes, and just really wear him down with a really secure position in half guard.
All right, so that opened up a cut around his eye area.
He hasn't moved his head well. He was taking shots too clean, and now a cut has opened up.
Well, ground and pound 101, and now you start to see some swelling appear. Seconds now to go in the opening round. Posture's up now. That's a vicious head strike. How'd he take it? Strickland's right back to the full mount.
He's very accurate in the ground and pound and is showing because he's landing so consistently.
Oh, he postures up in a big head strike by Strickland. For the end of round one. All right, so the round is over and you see some obvious bleeding now. Looks like the cut is on the nose. Yes, it is. Cut man will try to get in there and shut it, but of course, as soon as he absorbs a strike this next round, that thing could reopen. Certainly bears watching here moving forward. All right, let's check out some of the action, DC, and how about the punching acumen by that fighter in that previous round?
He does not waste anything. He does not loop punches. Everything's tight. Everything's precise. He's a sniper. We always talk about how he's a sniper. He is a sniper, and it showed in that exchange that allowed him to drop his opponent.
You ready to fight? Ready.
All right, second round underway. Oh, and he tags him with the straight. Nice job there by Du Plessis.
Hurt him with a left hook, yep.
Well, the left hook has been there at times, not that time. Oh, he lands another strike to the body, really starting to connect on a lot of shots to the midsection, and these will take their toll as this fight goes into the latter rounds. All right, well, that blow is fauceting from that cut with each strike landed, and he continues to effectively target that area.
We are talking about a guy with a super high fight IQ. So when you give him that blood, that crimson red is nothing more than something that inspires him to continue doing what he's doing. So you have got to change something. You got to get your head moving so you're not taking too much damage to that cut.
All right, has the guard closed here. Pretty good work with the strikes here off of his back by Du Plessis. Oh, his right eye keeps taking damage, looking pretty swollen now.
And now he's looking to choke.
Oh, he's got it locked in tight now. Oh, hang on a second, he escapes.
What a tremendous job. You saw his hands immediately go to the inside. Attack the lock, create some space, blow to your back, give up the mount, but live to fight another day.
Nice movement to avoid some of those strikes from the top.
Most fighters will tell you offensive wrestling is the hardest, most exhausting thing.
Especially if you're just running the guy over, Jonathan, he just gets up.
Just over 3 minutes to go. Postures up now and lands a devastating strike to the head.
Oh, he got to the spot.
Well, the ground and pound has been working for him. Nice job here by Du Plessis. Oh, he lands another strike to the body. He just continues to punish his opponent's midsection here in this round. Strickland's cheek looks like it's cut here, starting to bleed a little bit now. Slip that offering from his opponent. In the past, we've seen him sort of lean on the toughness. Tonight, he's leaning on the defense.
And you see the evolution of the fighter in front of us. He doesn't have to be tough anymore. The more he can slip strikes, the longer he can prolong his career.
Nice straight right, Lance. Well, eventually you know he's gonna turn this defense into offense, but he's certainly doing a nice job on the defensive end muscle.
They talk about the feeling out process. He's getting his opponent's timing. Now he's blocking everything. Expect counter as we go forward. Oh, he jumped guillotine right away.
Is tight. Oh, he is out. How good is that?
That is phenomenal submission defense by this young man.
Side control now, DC. A lot of options at his disposal from here. Du Plessis looking to lock up an arm bar here. Oh, he's got that arm in tight, DC. Strickland's eye appears to be closing up by the second. Here's the time!
Oh, my goodness!
With a massive highlight at the Garden.
Oh, boy!
Well, everybody in this arena still digesting this result. What a win for him tonight, and he gets it done by submission, no less.
He said he was going to get it done by submission. To watch an athlete call his shot is always fun. He should be very proud.
All right, so a wild round and a wild sequence there on the ground, DC. Talk us through the highlights.
He's such a phenomenal grappler. I don't understand how people don't know that this guy wants to submit you. He is the best grappler, best submission specialist we've seen in a long time.
We get the official decision from Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 59 seconds of round number two. Declaring the winner by submission due to an armbar and new UFC middleweight champion of the world, Dricus Du Plessis.
All right, so a major result here tonight as we continue to digest it. A submission win by the number one contender, and he is now the new UFC middleweight champion. A tough night for the incumbent, an amazing night for the challenger, and he is celebrating the result in his corner right now. Congratulations are in order to the undisputed new king at 185 pounds.